So this is round one, game three. So I just got beat down in the last game. I definitely had a player there. Forgot about that werewolf. The archer can target flying creatures even in the untransformed side. I think that cost me the game. Or it was close, so I might have lost anyways, but that definitely cost me the game. So this is the last round here. So it's important to note the times here. Oh yeah, so I wish there was a way to slow down this, but I ended up having horrible hands and going down to five, and he stayed at full grip. So I was already at a huge disadvantage going into the third game. The good news is he didn't play anything for a while. So I thought I had some chance to stabilize here. I actually boarded this in and took out shoot, I took out something I can't remember now. Because he was another zombie and I thought, with the endless ranks or endless numbers or whatever, that zombie spawning card would be good. And he actually didn't have anything to drop till turn four, so I got in for five, which is pretty sweet with this guy. And so I forbidden alchemied at the end of turn. Took the heron. Dropped these other cards. Decided I wanted to take out this guy. 4 for 3/2 first strike, and he gains life equal to toughness of guys he kills. That's pretty strong. So kill that guy, draw off my heron. Fortunately, he has a gravedigger, so he brings it right back. Two gravediggers, actually. So I swing with the heron, drop my zombies, thinking that I have this pretty under control. I have my own gravedigger too. So I drop the armored scab. I get a captain counterpart in the graveyard and some business in the graveyard too, unfortunately. But then he kills my guy, and he brings back this guy, the bane of my existence. This guy is insane every time I play against him. Totally insane. So I'm just trying to make sure that I don't die here to him. Make sure he doesn't flip. And then he drops his Geist Catcher, which is huge too. So I really have no way to attack into that. So alchemy again, get dead weight. Need some removal. Let's kill that ranger. So he flips. I'm like, great. So I play two spells to flip him and kill him. But not before he kills my snake, I think. Yeah, he kills my zombie snake. So things are still pretty stabilized right now. He drops a 4/4/5/5 trample, which is insane. I get back my snake, cast. No, I don't cast them. What do I do? Yeah, and then he casts this bomb right here, which is bonkers. She, with 7 mana, she can mind control anything you have. So that's insane, and I'm in trouble. So I draw the Scab Goliath, and I see that he has 7 mana, but you can't produce red without 8 mana. So you can't do all of this without 8. And I basically take the risk. I'm like, I have to start pounding in, and I can't with a 5/5 and a 4/5 blocking. So I take the risk. I drop the Scab Goliath, and I hope that he doesn't get his mana, which he does. So he takes over my Goliath, and that's really unfortunate for me. So I think I'm screwed at this point. He attacks. I triple block his boar. But luckily, I rip this off the top, and I can bounce his guy, get my Goliath back. And then I flash back the zombie token creator. And so he drops this werewolf, which now has +1, +0, and trample. And look at the time now. I'm relatively stabilized now. What I do here is I flashback counterpart to get two of these guys now, and I think I was about. I was thinking if he wasn't running out of time, I would have started to swing in, I think. I don't know if it would have been the smartest idea, because he could have just double blocked with these guys and only lost one of them. Probably would have killed the, I don't know. Anyways, it wouldn't have been profitable, and then he would have, but it wouldn't have been the greatest, because he has such beefy dudes. Then he drops the vampire again. But at this point, I was like, I'm just going to flash him back again and let him run the clock out. So I actually thought I was going to lose, because he dropped two crazy bombs. But luckily, I just ripped off the top that bounce spell, and I clocked him out. It's not a fancy, no fancy win here. It's not a no glorious win, but it did the job. So I advanced to the next round after that.